Something up. Up. Yeah, man. But I take them to a different topic now the day, yeah, you know. I take them to a serious topic now the day, yeah. Can I hear this now? This morning, my school chew me see somebody shave a pastor. There's somewhere in the state. But him now feel mouse and him do him look prayer thing to people, you know. And him do him prayer thing and me hear the man say, you know, if you just sow a seed, you know, make the thing keep on running. That you have to sow a seed, $18. You sow the seed there and they're blessing and everything. And then people call him and him have the little phone thing and put it on a prayer for people. And I say, why the pastor, if you do a service, why you want to charge your service? If you say you do a service and you say you help people or something, why you want to charge for that service? Because I mean, I understand it, you know. Because man can't say, yeah, you know, for make the thing go on, you know, the show go on. Because them we have a platform now, and I like, we go to a TV station and them set up some big cameras. And we broadcast across the world. Social media provide this platform free of charge. And then we don't pay a little internet bill, which even if you don't depend on social media, you still use internet. You still have to pay your internet bill because you watch the TV and do your thing. So I don't know when I say, you know, if it go on, so you have to pay him. I don't understand that, you know. Don't understand these things. You see what I say? Don't understand these things. Now, people see me upon religious attack and they never see me draw for your Bible. But me, I read the Bible too, you know. Because me see a next pastor. Me, I go back to the pastor. Yeah. Pastor, yeah, I forgot to look at Jabba do something and stop do that thing there. Stop saying yeah, pray for people. I know somebody from ICU. Yeah, you know, you're going to come out the ICU. But hear this now. But I see what's not. In a life. Every day baby born. That's why I'm gonna believe in the horoscope. Every day baby born, every day people dead. Every day you have accident, somewhere across the world. Somebody are drowned, somebody are traveling a plane. People, millions of people are traveling a plane. In a ship to go up on cruise and things. That is just a circle of life. You understand? So when a man say, I see you, somebody, I feel it, I see you. You have people are going to ICU every day. Some of them are going to come out and some of them not going to come out. Some of them are going to come out in a body bag. And some are going to come out, get better and go back home. Yeah? But no man no come to me and say, okay, because in prayer and you call him and they start flourishing with money and him need this money for carry on. Maybe I know you have to get paid for do, you know, if you do a service. Me I do a service and we say, well, I clean up the police them in Jamaica and try and clean and get rid of the crime and point out the bad eggs them because you don't have nobody that do that. Saying, and you can't just say the YouTube them. We not ask somebody about donation. Everybody say, me put up about donation, me not do that. You understand? And then when me talk, no, somebody just come to mind and say, yes, man, you have enough more people that do it, you know. Them do vlogging and them put up like them PayPal account. For do what? We are pay them for? Come on now, man. All them thing, they, everything the people have, you have put a donation to something, man. You know. If somebody, if you do something like that, unless you can donate something, if you got help some poverty-driven, poverty-stricken people, a family, you know, some poorer class of people, you know, say so you send back some kids to school and you raise the money for you to do that. But you know, that about if you come make you do your work and people if you come donate. Donate what? Come on. Me a youth call me yesterday to and ask me about an interview. But me tell him some interview, I really vet you. Because what I do, you know, like you have a big track record and thing, you know, the business long time. Me keep the real authentic reggae music alive. See? So you have some people now, you know, with the boy, you know, where 10 years ago, they never listen music. They are 10. Them turn 20 now. You know, 15, 20 years ago, they never, you know, they know the tune, but they know which artist we. No, me give them a platform. You see me, I say, so, you know, you reserve the history of the music, you know, you see? So, me give them a platform for that. So, when them ask me, I know that me really interview young artists. Me not really, not have nothing, me not fight against them, you know? But me not listen to certain music, you know, so certain man, me not, you see me, I say? That's a real kettle than a real thing. But you just want to keep it there, so you know you have a platform where you set up a channel where you deal with. Yeah, man, you have to preserve the history of the music and keep it there, so you know, this I keep it. You see me, I said, so I just explained to him, and he asked me, how much me charge me to charge? No, man. The money thing, they know my style, that man. No, man, I'm Barry G and them for them style back in the days and them from IRFM and some other place. Some people afraid for talk, me not afraid for talk, you know. Yeah, it's not about charge, man. Yeah, preserve the music. You see me, I say, you love the music, preserve the music. We keep shows, we do things, you know. As artists and as producers, we produce record and them thing there, but when I do them interview, we don't put no charge, you know. We don't come in like some of the TV station or in a yard, we put some charge to certain people and then push them and say some things to hype them up, we don't go so. We don't know that. You know, we just want to keep it real, you know. Keep my thing on a real level. You see me, I say. As I tell you before, I never read the Bible when I do religious art, but me, you're a pastor. I think last week, I say, them have dildo, and I show them, say, we have sex in the Bible, and I talk about two sisters, and thing. But I know that's a part of the Bible, they tell you, you know. You see, the Bible have certain things, if you don't read with understanding, you get led astray, and don't get led astray by some pastor, why misquote the Bible. And when they misquote the Bible, them just tell people anything, and you run with it. When you hear a woman, and you say a woman, not literally mean woman. And the Bible itself, if you read the chapter, read the scriptures, it explains to you. Like, may I read that Revelation now? I may read it out because it takes the time and read it out. I may show you something. See? Because it tell about woman. Take my time read out this. Can I read out from so much scripture? And I'm the one, I'm going to step my time through this. And it's going to explain me so far this go. Me so far this go. I never want to skip out no night, you know. Yeah. I never want to skip out no night. Yeah. The woman and the dragon. Then a great and mysterious sight appears in the sky. There was a woman, you know, whose dress was the sun, and who had moon under her feet and a crown of 12 stars on her head. But although this is a woman, if when you read go through it, you know, it's not a woman. She was soon to give birth. You hear tell about her birth, you know. And the pain and the suffering of childbirth made her cry out. Now you have, that I come and see the pastor, we don't tell people about dildo and anus and why them burn things and do all kind of things. Stop misquote the Bible, man, and read the Bible, man, because you have problems in the Bible, and you read, if you read it, understanding, you see what the Bible has said, simple. Another mysterious sight appeared in the sky. There was a huge red dragon with 7 heads, 10 arms, and a crown on each of the heads. With his tail, he dragged a third of the stars out of the sky and threw it down on the earth. And he stood in front of the woman in order to eat her child as soon as it was born. Then she gave birth to a son. You see that talk like I just, you know, just listen good, you know. Who will rule over all nations with an iron rod. But the child was snatched away and taken to God and his throne. And the woman fled to the desert, to a place God had prepared for her, where she will be taken care of for 1,260 days. Then war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angel fight against the dragon and fought back with his angel. But the dragon was defeated, and he and his angel were not allowed to stay in heaven any longer. The huge dragon was thrown out to the ancient serpent called the devil, or Satan, that deceived the whole world. He was thrown down to earth, and all the angels with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now God's salvation has come. Now God has shown his power as king. Now this Messiah has shown his authority for the one who stood before our God and accused our brothers and sisters day and night has been thrown out of heaven. Our brothers and sisters won the victory over him by the blood of the Lamb and by the truth which they proclaim, and they were willing to give up their lives and die. And so be glad, the heaven and all you that live there. But oh, terrible for the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you and is filled with rage because he knows that he has only a little time left. When the dragon realized that he had been thrown down to earth, he began to pursue the woman who had given birth to the boy. She was given two wings of a large eagle in order to fly to her places. Now when we read Bible and them thing there, you know, me read with enough understanding. So it tell you can't know what about the boat. You know, it tell about eagle, tell about star, about moon, it tell about certain things, it tell about clothes, the kind of clothes them wear and things. So I read and me take a note of everything, you know. When me I read, you know. In the desert, desert, tell about desert, where she will be taken care of for 3.5 years. Safe from the dragon attack, and then from his mouth, the dragon pour out a flood of water. You ain't tell about flood. After the woman, so that it would carry her away. But the earth helped the woman. It opened its mouth and swallowed the water that had come from the dragon mouth. The dragon was furious with the woman and went off to fight against the rest of her descendants. So he tells the woman and the descendants and all those who obey God's commandment and are faithful to the truth revealed by Jesus. And the dragon stood on the seashore. Now some reach 13 now. Yeah? The beast. So I can read this and it'll explain who the woman was. Because it's not literally a woman, you know. And yesterday I've passed, so like the one where I watched the other day, I read. And I said, see there, and them are this, and them are that, and see, I tell about that woman, and tell about the two sisters. Nah. Tell about places and things, man. Them to stop mislead people. Then I saw the beast coming up out of the sea. It had 10 arms, 7 heads, and each of the arms there was a crown, and each of the heads there was name that was insulting to God. And the beast looked like a leopard with feet like bear's feet, a mouth like a lion mouth. The dragon gave the beast his own power, his throne, and his vast authority. One of the head of the beast seemed to have been fatally wounded, but the wound had healed. The whole earth was amazed and followed the beast. Everyone worship the dragon because he has given his authority to the beast. They worship the beast, also saying, who is like the beast? Who can fight against it? The beast was allowed to make proud claims which were insulting to God, and it was permitted to have authority for 42 months. It began to curse God, its name. Oh, man. Who this I know? Yeah, man. Who this I call me now? Okay. Yes, sir. What? Me dey pa me live, man. Me dey pa me soon call you back.
Yeah, boy, clean up on Sunday.
Yeah, man.
You see me out?
Yeah.
How family, you
know? How joke can I make? Yeah.
Everybody that care for the brother. You and him brother.
Serious.
No family man.
A lie. Yeah. So them where them do crashing at him and then the police shoot him?
Well, we don't know if full of children blood creep, but we know some murder. He care tap on the police go and go shoot him, brother.
Skaka I know him did that arm. Him doing nothing. Yeah. You see that? Yeah. Yeah. Jano. Anytime I don't call you back and talk to you, because I'm live. I mean, I hear that right now, because I burn out that from yesterday, you know. You see them man, then give them man the bail, and them man they can go and sit and cause that innocent people life. So if them a run down one car and lick in the next car, you can't go mash up the other man. You understand?
I'm babies.
Yeah, right. Later. Yeah, man. Cool. Yeah, man. Sad news just come in, you know. Yeah, man. Right, so I finished that. I may have to go back on that because you hear that now. Sometimes something closer to where we even think, you know. Okay, that are the car where I'm crashing at the, you know, the police, they might try to escape. And then the police go over because they knock out in him and the lady in the car. A family in the car, can I see the family just call me, I tell me. And them go over and knock him. And the woman, like, she wake up back and I say, no, we boom, bam, bam. Because I want to them that run down with the police, them. But you can go crash now that, no, like the police, they get mad and when they go knock them just gonna knock them over there, such a. Get innocent people in some little things to foolishness, you know. Yeah, man. Let me see what I reach now. All right, let me see what I reach now. Beach will make to make proud, but how far I reach down on this now. It began to curse God his name, the place where we live, and all who live in heaven. It was allowed to fight against God's people and to defeat them, and it was given authority over every tribe, nation, language, and race. Listen good, all people living on earth will worship it, except those whose names were written before the creation of the world and the book of the living, which belongs to the Lamb that was killed. Listen then, if you have ears, if you have ears, whoever is meant to be captured will surely be captured. Whoever is meant to be killed by the sword will surely be killed by the sword. This call for endurance and faith and part of God's people. Then I saw another beast which came out of the earth. It had two arms like a lamb's arm, and it spoke like a dragon. It used the vast authority of the first beast in its presence. It forced the earth and all who live on it to worship the first beast, who wounds and heal. The second beast perform great miracle. You hear this? I saw me watch some of them have false prophet and them thing there, you know. It made fire come down out of heaven to earth in the sight of everyone. And it deceived all the people living on earth by means of miracle which it was allowed to perform in the presence of the first beast. The beast told them to build an image in the honor of the beast that had been wounded by the sword and yet live. The second beast was allowed to breathe life into the image of the first beast so that the image could talk and put death all those who would not worship it. The beast forced all people, small, great, rich and poor, slave and free. So back in the days, you know, say so it have. You hear it says slave and free. Let me tell you, I read with a lot of meaning in this, so you know. I have to read with meanings, you know. Slave and, let me see what I read now. Slave and free, yeah? Defeat living, let me see now. Let me just say this. Poor, yeah, slave and free, yeah, slave and free. Okay. To have the mark of the beast on their right hand and in them forehead. No one could buy or sell without having this mark. That is the beast's name or the number that stands for the name. This is called the wisdom. This is called wisdom. Whoever is intelligent can work out the meaning of the number of the beast, because the number stand for a human name. Its number is 666. The lamb and that. All right, reach 14. So it identify the woman. That come here some pastor identify her about this and that and all kind of things. See? Then I look And there was a lamb standing on Mount Zion. With him were 144,000 people who have his name and his father's name written on their forehead. And I heard a voice from heaven that sounded like a roaring waterfall, like a loud peal of thunder. You see, I have thunder. You see, thunder. It sounded like the music, made by a musician playing their harps. It's a long musician, the board. Yeah. The 144,000 stood before the throne. The four living creatures and the elders, they were singing a new song, which only they could learn. They are the only ones who have been redeemed. They are the men who have kept themselves pure by not having sexual relationship with the woman, with women. They are virgins. They follow the Lamb wherever he goes. They have been redeemed from the rest of human race and are the first one to be offered to God and of the Lamb. They have never been known to tell lies. They are faultless. Then I saw another angel flying high in the air with an eternal message of God, good news, to announce to the people of the earth, to every race, tribe, language, and nation. So, you know, so you have different tribe, language, race, and nation at the time. Because he said every race, you know, tribe, language, and nation. He said in the Lord's voice, honor God and praise the greatness, for the time has come for him to judge, worship him who made heaven and earth, sea, and the spring of water. Second angel followed the first one, saying, she has fallen. Great Babylon. You say she has fallen. And you where she said fall at the woman this attack. Yeah? Great Babylon has fallen. So she, what am I talking about? It was a city, Babylon. She made all people drink her wine. You can't, it's sitting in the Bible, you know. I have, like when I say the pastor read and I talk about one, boom, bam, bam. And when I say she, like him, I refer to a woman. But really, it was a reference to a city. Saying, drink our wine, the strong wine of her immortal lust. A third angel followed the first two, saying in a loud voice, whoever worship the beast and his image and receive the mark on their forehead and their hands will then themselves drink good God's wine, the wine of his fury, which has poured out full strength into the cup of his anger. All who do this will be tormented in fire and sulfur before the holy angel and the Lamb. The smoke of the fire that tormented goes up in forever and ever. There is no relief day and night for those who worship the beast and his image, for everyone who has mark of his name. This call for endurance on the part of God people. Those who obey God can commandment and the faithful of Jesus. Then I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this happy are those who from now and die in the service of the Lord. Yes, indeed, answer the Spirit, they will enjoy the rest of their hard work because the result of the service go with them. I think I also know when I read and it'll tell you who and who, where everything mean, yeah? Then I look, and there was a white cloud, and sitting on the cloud was what looked like a human being with a crown of gold. It's a gold and everything, they hear everything, you know. And his head, and a sharp sickle in his hand. Then another angel came out of the temple and cried out a loud voice to one who was sitting on the cloud, use your sickle and reap the harvest, because the time has come. the earth is ripe for the harvest. Then one who sat on the cloud swung his sickle on the earth, and the earth harvest was reaped. And I saw another angel came out of the temple in heaven, and he also had a sharp sickle. Then another angel who was in charge of the fire came from the altar, and he shouted in the loud voice to the angel who had the sharp sickle, "Use your sickle and cut the grapes from the vineyard of the earth, because the grapes are ripe." So the angel swung his sickle on the earth, cut the grape from the vine, and threw them in the wine press of God's furious anger. The grape were squeezed out in the wine press outside the city, and the blood came out of the wine press in a flood 300 kilometers long and nearly 2 meters wide. Yeah? Then I saw the sky, another mysterious sight, great and amazing. There were 7 angels with 7 plagues, and the last one, because they are final expression of God's anger. Then I saw what looked like a sea of glass mixed with fire. I also saw those who had won the victory over the beast and the image, and over the one whose name is represented by the number. They were standing by the sea of the glass, holding harps, and God had given them, and singing the songs of Moses and servant of God, and the songs of the Lamb. Lord God Almighty, O great and wonderful your deeds, kings of the nation, O right and O true are your ways. Who will not stand in awe of you, O Lord? Who will refuse to decline your greatness? You alone are holy. All the nation will come and worship you, because your just action are seen by all. After this, I saw the temple in heaven open with a secret tent in it. The 7 angels and the 7 plagues came out of the temple dressed in clean, shine linen. You see shining linen here. Let me tell you about that linen and them thing there. When I read, I pick out certain words, you know. And with the gold belt, yeah, belts, you know, tied around their chest. Then one of 4 living creatures gave the 7 angels 7 gold bowls full of anger of God, who lives forever and ever. And the temple was filled with smoke from the glory and the power of God. And no one could go into the temple until the 7 plagues brought by the 7 angels had come to the end. I heard a loud voice speaking from the temple to the 7 angels, "Go and pour out 7 bowls of God's anger to the earth." The first angel went and poured out his bowl on the earth. Terrible and painful sores appears, and those who had mark of the beast, and those who had worshipped the image. Then a second angel poured out the bowl in the sea, and water became like the blood of the dead person, every living creature in the sea dead. Then a third angel poured out his bowl, and the rivers and the spring of waters, and they turned into blood. And I heard the angel in charge of water say, the judgment you have made are just, Holy One. You who are and who were, they pour out the blood of God people, of the prophet, and so you have given them blood to drink. They are getting what they deserve. Then I heard the voice from the altar saying, "Lord God Almighty, true and just indeed in your judgment. Then the fourth angel poured out his bowl on the sun, and it was allowed to burn people with its fury heat. Then they were burnt by fierce heat, and they cursed the name of God, who was authority of this plague. But they will not turn from their sins and praise his greatness. So them stubborn. Then the fifth angel poured out his bowl on the throne of the beast. Darkness fell over the beast kingdom, and the people bit their tongue because of their pain, and they were cursed the God of heaven for their pain and sores, but they did not turn from their evil ways. That means them just want to keep evil. And then the sixth angel poured out his bowl of great river Euphrates. So Euphrates, you don't know, say Iraq. See? So this, when you read out this, it tell you Euphrates knows Iraq. The river dry up to provide a way for the kings who came from the east. Then I saw three unclean spirits that look like frog. They were coming out of the mouth of the dragon, and the mouth of the beast, and the mouth of the false prophet. They are the spirit of demons that perform miracles. These three spirits go out, all the kings of the world, to bring them together for the battle of the great day of Almighty God. Listen, I'm coming like a thief. Happy is who stay awake and guard his clothes, so that he will not walk around naked and be ashamed in the public. Tell about naked public clothes, everything. You see it? Then the spirit brought the king together in the place that in Hebrew is called Armageddon. Then the seventh angel poured out his bowl in the air, and a loud voice came from the throne in the temple saying, it is done. There were flashes of lightning, rumbling and peal of thunder, and terrible earthquake. There had never been such earthquake since creation of human race. Say, but now this is, you see, you have earthquake, lightning, and thunder, everything the same way. You see, this was the worst earthquake of all. The great city was split into three parts. The great city. Remember what I talk about the woman and them things, right? Yeah? The city. Yeah, man. Great city. There are three parts. And the city of all countries were destroyed. The city of all countries were destroyed. God remembered great Babylon and made her drink the wine from its cup, the wine of its furious anger. All the island disappear, all the mountain vanish, the huge hillstone, each weighing as much as 50 kilograms, fell from the sky upon and peoples who curse God on account of plague of ill, because it was such a terrible plague. God, they curse God, you know. Then one of the seven angels, who are the seven bowls, came to me and said, come, and I will show you all the famous prostitute. Here it says prostitute. The famous prostitute is to be punished. Then that great city that is built near many rivers, the king of the earth practice sexual immorality with her. The king of the earth in a practice that, you know. And the people of the world became drunk from drinking the wine of her immorality. Seeing? The spirit took control of me and the angel carried me to the desert, and I saw a woman sitting on the red beast that had name insulting to God written all over it, and the beast had 7 heads and 10 horns, and the woman was dressed in purple and scarlet, you see all colors and clothes, eh? And covered with gold ornaments, precious stones, pearls in her hands. She is a like a normal woman, you know, just listening, you know. And this away, we and pastor them go wrong. She held a gold cup full of absence and filthy things, the result of her immorality, and her forehead was written name as a secret meaning, Great Babylon, the mother of all the prostitute. You hear what name? Great Babylon, the mother of all the prostitute. Pervert in the world. And I saw that the woman was drunk with the blood of God's people and the blood of those who were killed because they had been loyal to Jesus. When I saw her, I was completely amazed. Why are you amazed? The angel asked me. I will tell you the secret meaning of the woman and the beast that carry her. The beast with 7 heads and 10 horns. That beast was once alive, but live no longer. It's about to come up from the abyss and will go off to be destroyed to the people living on the earth, whose name have not been written before the creation of the world in the book of the living. With all their maze as they look at the beast, it was once alive. Now it no longer lives, but it will reappear. This call for wisdom and understanding. The 7 head are 7 hills. This is when that dream about. The 7 heads, where you say it up 7 heads. And which the woman sit. There are also 7 kings. 7 kings. Yeah? 5 of them are fallen. 1 still rule. Me dey pa my live here. Call me back. Yeah? Yeah, man. Let me say yes or no. 7 kings. 1 still rules. And the other one has not yet come. Yeah, and then I say no, yeah, man. All right, 7 heads, 5 that 1, yeah, and the other one has not yet still come. When he comes, he must rule only a little while. And the beast that was once alive but live no longer, it itself is 8 king, who is 1 of the 7 and is going off to be destroyed. Then 10 arms you saw are 10 kings. See, it tell about the meaning of the things them know. Who have not yet begun to rule, but who will be given authority to rule as king for an hour with the beast. These 10 all have the same purpose, and they give their power and authority to the beast. They will fight against the lamb, but the lamb together with his call chosen and faithful followers will defeat them, because he's the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. The angel also said to me, the waters you saw and which the prostitute is sitting. The description. The prostitute is sitting. A nation, people, races and languages. The 10 horns you saw and the beast will eat the prostitute. They will take away everything she has and leave her naked. They will eat her flesh and destroy her with fire. For God has placed in their heart that they will carry out this purpose by acting together and giving the beast their power truth until God word come true. The woman you saw in the great, the woman you saw is the great city that ruled over the kings of the earth. And that's when I stop reading. Because it tells us that the woman you saw at the great city of Babylon. That's why I'm not sure. See that great city, see Babylon there. So you see, you have some, like, as I said, I see the pastor read in book the other day, and I quote the next thing that are about two sisters and this and that and the Mahalat and them thing. They tell you. They tell you in the Revelation same way. She all that and drink this and do that. But I know because of them in the city, what them I do? So it's style woman as the city as a woman. You see it? And these are what them do, you know. Sometimes you have to take a thing and read for yourself, too, you know, because it have everything right there. So and you have some people just mislead people and carry them astray. I mean, I understand past about you can broadcast free, just press a button and you broadcast live and you want people to get $18 for sow a seed. What kind of seed? Kalalo seed? Go buy a kalalo seed and sow it. Everyone pop chug or sow it or something. You understand? Stop swindling the people, man. Because if you have spread the word of love or something and you want people, no, nobody fuss and fight and them thing. The way you have to charge people for what? You know your house, like I come me strong in my studio now. And me, I do a service like me, say, all right, too much people are dead in Jamaica and them thing. That we know say police corrupted. And we know say them are kill people. And we know say have other man, them use other youth to another pay killings and pay either things that go on. So we do know, we now stand feet, because if we keep silent, I consent. You know, because every year we have over 2,000 people dead. 1,600 plus police kill an extra 200 or 200 or something. And, you know, that different from a doctor kill, because them they knock out. When doctor kill people in Jamaica, you don't get account for that. Bad injection, bad anything, no account to give to that. And we feast them for start with account, because them commit even more murder than where people get a gunshot for. Anybody injection, you're just dead. And from doctor say you're dead, nothing else, them just wrap you up and just turn over your body, and you go bury and it for stop. See? So we have enough thing where we want to address. But stop making them pass there. Both them I read Bible and a quote, where they want to quote to you. Yeah, me go pan with this talk. Me never have to quote the Bible, cause me know verse and scriptures, and me know when me read. See, so me gonna try proof to and say, you know, the Bible coming up in enough things, enough parables, enough saying. A matter of fact, you did have the slave Bible. Enough people not even know about. Say have the slave Bible, of course. Me say me can't get a little touch of it before me sign off. So, man, when I see the slave Bible, you know, right there. Let's see if it's in this. If you know this, in that term, I use a shoot, so you might not see it one day, I'm showing it here. But it's the slave Bible, man. I'm never see if it's in this. I'm going to save this. No, I'm never see if it's in this. You know? Let's see this.
Inside Washington's Museum of the Bible, a single volume that is like no other. The so-called Slave Bible. Remarkable not for what's in it, but for what's not.
So about 90% of the Old Testament's been removed, and about 50% of the New Testament's been removed. To put it another way, a normal King James Version has 1,189 chapters in it. The Slave Bible has only 232.
Missing are chapters and verses that might have encouraged uprisings. Book of Exodus, redacted. No story of Moses demanding Pharaoh, let my people go. Gone is Galatians, and the verse, there is neither bond nor free, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. And no Jeremiah, woe unto him that useth his neighbor's service without wages.
What they've left in are verses such as Ephesians 6:5, which is the famous verse, slaves, be obedient to your master.
Looking at this Bible, it's hard to tell that anything's been taken out of it.
That's correct. I mean, it looks like a normal book. For many enslaved Africans, this would have been the first time they were exposed to the Bible.
A Bible selectively edited to instill obedience, using religion to underpin the horror of slavery. When people encounter this exhibit, what lasting impression do you want them to leave with?
Well, we want to pass the message on that may this never happen again. The Bible itself is a whole book. It's not one that you get to carve up and use this piece or that piece.
The slave Bible designed to repress rebellion, but it didn't work. Enslaved people in the Caribbean constantly fought against slavery until emancipation.
I think it's very relevant to understand our history, not just American history, but our African-American history, our roots and how we got to this point.
A dark chapter in the history of the good book. Jeff Bennett, NBC News, Washington.
So you see, NBC News. Say enough people never know that, you know? Them have all kind of things and them use the Bible for oppress people and all kind of things. But you have to just go and live good. I know, say, there is a creator, you know, most a creator. Earth couldn't create itself. Earth could not create itself. So I'm not following a man. I'm not following a man. But you can't make the lead me astray. You can't just give me a book. And you print it and just lead me astray and put where you want to put on things. See, them have an edit version. Because let me tell you this. The core of the earth are always fiery. That means mankind, them say them create fire, never create fire. Because the Bible tell about fire a long time. I think, you see me, I say? I have a volcano. So it always hot. But can you imagine now, man, it takes up something, I say, the sun tonight, 93 million miles from the earth. So if you think of it, when the sun get all hot in some place, so it's mad. The thing properly made, man. Because if it's 93 million miles and you feel the sun them kind of way, then you have certain things where sun burn you up, man, mash you up. See? Can you imagine we're there a million miles closer? We're not fry, man. Or if we're there a million miles further, we freeze. Not only the earth. So, you know, say, you know, you can't think of a million things if you know, say, the earth properly made. You see me, I say? Yeah, man. So the man now come tell me, say, hey, yeah, man, this and that, because you won't do it. You just create yourself. But no man now bring no pagan nothing to me and tell me nothing and go in my head and, like, no, I can't do that. A man stop for using name of God and them things and swindle people, them money and all kind of things that reach out for them and people follow them, you know. Oh yeah, man, him just pray for me because me the sick man I come out, either you get better or you're dead. Either two things. Or you crippled up or something. So, you know, are you have just you instead of you tell a man to pray for yourself and you believe in a prayer, just pray for yourself. You know, tell a man to come pray for you. Yeah. If you believe in yourself, if you believe in yourself, or when a man pray for you and say something to you, you can't do it. If me forget up on me if you go vice something, a man say my prayer for me for me vice. I mean I know if you do one, but I'm not gonna do it. I mean, I'm afraid to press my key and teach myself certain to do certain things. I mean, I can't do it. No, I can't do it. You understand? I mean, about the trick on the man. I'm taking the money. That them things never stop, man. You see me? I say, I'm there here. Lonesome. We're there. Just keep it there and keep it with. And the pastor, I tell people about one. And you have some people now, I tell people about send them money by PayPal and to keep them thing going. Keep what going? What are you doing? What are you doing? If you do a service, I want to say, when I help you. Do this and do that. I wanna. Me not see what we need money for. People are pay on for do it. That's a joke. If you have pray for somebody, people have to pay $18 and sow a seed. Now, so I'm gonna buy my seed. Them and throw them myself, man. My good man. You understand? Man, not come up and come up and a thing where him not pay for broadcast. And I like it to cost him the money. Him just touch a thing and it broadcast. Seeing the platform, they're there for we now. But we can use every one platform. And that I use it for just saying, send and sow seed and hundred and mighty. Like, I couldn't want to treat people. Stop the foolishness, yeah? But they are lonesome, yeah? Up. Oh.